You know, Chaotic Chris and myself, the Double D, we were so excited about our upcoming match with the Heartbreak Express that we had to check out the news on that newfangled internet thing.
You know, I was reading on there today that Fabulous Phil was sick! Wow, what a coincidence, Heartbreaks. You know, we were this close to capturing the AWA Tag Team titles in Boyden a month ago. So of course Fabulous Phil was gonna be sick!
Well, you know what we're sick of, Heartbreak Express? We're sick of you ducking the Double D because you got scared at the Boynton Beach Show when we almost captured those AWA World Tag Team titles. Well, we'll get our another shot. But tonight, it's not the Heartbreak Express. It's half, or I guess two-thirds in this case. It's Sean Davis, Keith Blonde against the Dynamic Duo tonight.
Keith Blonde. Look at his hair. There's no way that that is his natural hair color. You know, I've seen some really bad hairdos in my day, you know, flying above the skies, doing all things that us superheroes do. But I must say, Keith Blonde, that is the worst hair I have ever seen in my life. It makes me sick!
Tommy Vandal back here in South Florida. Who invited him back here?
He invited himself back here. He's got issues to deal with here, himself and Kimberly. Is Kimberly looking great on the outside of the ring, Frank? And even someone who's not into females like you would have to appreciate the way that she is looking here this evening.
First of all, you're making things up again about the whole not into females thing. But I don't appreciate Kimberly being here. I don't appreciate Tommy Vandal being here. I did not approve of this.
Well, you may not.
I was not consulted.
You were not consulted? I don't think you have to be consulted for the issues that they're dealing with, which is your man, by the way, that we need to figure out how you gained alliance with, New Attitude Johnny Vandal. Would you care to tackle that subject here today?
Can we
talk about
simple.
How you got together?
I'm the premier manager in the wrestling business today. Johnny Vandal, up-and-coming superstar, has an attitude that I like. He has abilities that I like. I signed to a contract, pure and simple. This man is going straight to the top. Now you got his ingrateful brother showing up out of nowhere, seeing his brother having some success. He's jealous. He shows up, brings that skank along with him.
You called her a skank? Why would you call her a skank, Frank? And what does that make seven?
A very elegant and classy young woman.
I see. Especially the way that she slaps a falcon around and does all these things.
Well, anyone's allowed to slap a falcon around.
Unbelievable.
He's Asian.
Yeah.
And Tommy Vandal, he's trying to slap Jerome Hendrix around, it looks like, a little bit.
Yeah, I don't like Jerome Hendrix's chances here against a motivated Tommy Vandal, who will get his hands on Johnny one of these days, and probably you as well. I hope she gets her hands on you.
Don't
call her
give
skank.
Them, no, don't give them ideas. No,
give them plenty of ideas.
Do not
Frank.
Need to be encouraging their behavior.
Well, you're the one that's harboring a fugitive. He's the one that beat them down in the center of the ring, put his hands on a woman, destroyed them both. That's his flesh and blood, Frank. It's ridiculous. You're harboring the fugitive.
Tommy Vandal was an anchor.
He was an anchor.
He was dragging his brother down, preventing him from achieving pure superstardom he deserves.
Ah, see.
Superstardom that I can bring to him.
That's
he was never going to make it anywhere with that brother of his hanging around.
And that's straight out of the mouth of who? Johnny Vandal? That's what Johnny Vandal says. That's his skewed perception. It's not what any of us that watched them wrestle together said. So I'm going to say that Ricky Vandal's like a yacht then hanging on instead of just a boat anchor.
There's only one good Vandal, that's Johnny Vandal. He's a supreme member of that family. He doesn't need any of them anymore.
His attitude is ugly.
And he's winning. Johnny Vandal is now a winner.
He's a winner by cheating every single time out.
Hey, take a look at his win-loss record so far in the past 6 months. Tell me what you think about that.
Yeah, exactly. He's probably 6-8, 10-0. But he should have been disqualified in every single match. What do you say about that?
I say he's on a roll. He's undefeated since going to the New Attitude. And I can't be any happier with the newest member of my family.
Well, I'm going to tell you right this minute, that Tommy Vandal and Kimberly will get their hands on Johnny Vandal and yourself, and it will happen. They will find you.
Let's let Tommy Vandal worry about Jerome Hendrix first. Let me get past this match.
Jerome Hendrix. Well, Jerome Hendrix has the upper hand right this minute. Proving to be a decent challenge for Tommy Vandal thus far. I'll tell you, you're not making friends with very many people out there, are you? You got the Falcon after you. You got Tommy Vandal, Kimberly after you. And what is the thing with Loose Cipher?
I don't know what you're talking about.
What do you mean you don't know what I'm talking about?
You're just imagining things again. And look at Jerome. He just took Tommy Vandal, threw him through the ropes to the outside.
I'm imagining things. Okay. All right. You're going to have to address that at some point too, Frank. People want to know.
People don't need to know anything. They were born ignorant. They can say that way.
Great. On the outside, Jerome Hendrix. He just go after Kimberly? He's going after Kimberly. And she socked him for his trouble.
See, that's why I tell you that woman's a skank.
She's not a skank. He tried to hit her.
You don't know what she said to him on the outside. She has a dirty mouth.
Really? Well, fill us in.
Not that kind. You get your mind out of the gutter. Like cursing like a sailor out there. Probably made fun of the man's mother.
Wow. Well, what has she said to you? Do you have any insight you can lend us?
I don't even want to repeat the things that she said.
Really? That bad?
What do you expect from someone to be hanging out with Tommy Vandal? Low class all around there.
I don't agree, but you know what? You've been around him more than I have, so we'll take your words into consideration. That's about it. Full body slam by Jerome Hendrix in the center of the ring. Jerome Hendrix looking pretty good so far, Frank.
Yes, he is.
Not making a slouchy effort here, but that didn't look so good. Actually, that really didn't look so good.
Went for the high-risk maneuver, didn't pay off that time. But he's still done a lot of damage so far. Tommy Vandal not able to make it back to his feet yet. Maybe that scouting report I gave him helped out a little bit.
Now you're giving opponents scouting reports, Frank?
Well, I have resources at my disposal. If someone's going to face one of my enemies, they get the use of the scouting reports.
So you're using Vandal to ward off the Falcon and to try to damage him, so you're using him, and then you're using Seven to help out with reports, probably. Tell me Seven delivered that report.
That's a possibility.
Yeah. Frank, the master user. There's a reverse elbow in the center of the ring. Setting up for something, Frank. Just waiting on the man to get up. Super kick caught by Jerome Hendrix, and I'm surprised. Underneath the clothesline, though. Interesting placement on that one, but he got it. He got it full.
One more time.
And there's the one upside the head. The first one almost caved his hip in, Frank. Clothesline took his head off, folded him inside out. Here's a cover, and that's gonna do it. Tommy Vandal is on the warpath, Frank. And he and Kimberly are coming straight for you and Seven and Johnny and your whole crew.
They just better be careful. They don't know who they're messing with.
I guess they're going to find out soon enough, so will all of us.
Well, I've got plenty of resources at my disposal. And if this guy wants to come and align himself with the Falcon and come after me, they're all going to pay the price.
Well, you heard it here first. The words of Fabulous Frank. Only time will tell.